So as the brethren of Joseph and the brethren of Yahushua or Jesus, as the brethren hated the Heru, hated the one who was the chosen, the one who was the Christ figure or the anointed figure, both of them rejected the superior claims. Like many of the Hebrew Israelites, the black Hebrews, like though we are agreed about the identity of this lost sheep and this lost people. You understand? Though we're agreed about the prophecies concerning this lost and cursed people over here in the West, in the Americas, in the Caribbean, we're not agreed on the identity of Christ and his kingly character, even though we can present evidence, abundant evidence, even though there's abundant evidence for any who seek the truth will find the truth. But then don't stress yourself about it. You understand? Don't be stressed about it. Izo. You know what I mean? I mean, don't stress yourself about many of our so-called Hebrew Israelite brethren who blaspheme and who curse our Godfather, the King of Kings, our kinsman Redeemer, the King of Israel, upon the throne of great King David. This is the reality that we're speaking about. You understand? No matter how they try to blaspheme he who is him, Kadamawi Haile Selassie, they cannot shake the truth from his place. But even his majesty gives insight. It is what? Error, envy, or ignorance. That's the key, if we look at that. Or ignorance, error, and envy, in that order. It's ignorance. It's not knowing first. Ignorance. It's error. Because in their ignorance, they accept a lot of things to be true that are not true. Namely, the blasphemy against Kedemawi Haile Selassie and rejecting his superior claim. So we have ignorance, error, and this is what develops the envy. If you listen to what a lot of the haters, especially a lot of our so-called Hebrew Israelite brethren, and we will call them brethren. We're not ashamed that they are brethren according to the flesh, but spiritually, there's a lot of shame that they heap on the good name of Rastafari and on the superior claims of His Imperial Majesty, Kedemawi Haile Selassie. But in this particular Torah, sabbatical study and reading, when we study that Joseph himself was a type of Christos, and we look at the seven of the main analogies concerning Joseph and Yahushua. Let's go over this again and put this in now the light of our kinsman Redeemer, in the light of Rastafari revelation, the light of Christ's kingly character, in the light of Kedemawi Haile Selassie, Moa Anbesa Zem Negeda Yehuda, the conquering line of the tribe of Judah. First, it says that they were special objects of the Father's love. Now, here we have to look at the fact of Ethiopia. You see what I'm saying? Ethiopia shall stretch forth her hands to God. Ethiopia, in that sense, is that woman that we find in Revelation. And therefore, that her seed, speaking of that remnant, Yosef, that Beta Israel, and that Davidic remnant, Solomonic remnant, in the highlands of Ethiopia, Abyssinia, if you please, be it as it may, there's the link of the special objects of the Father's love vis-a-vis the Son of Man, vis-a-vis Lij Tefari. And even Lij Tefari, that man-child, was an especial object of his own father, Ras Mekonnen's love as well. So we have a link, a very important, a very powerful link we have there as well. Now, the important part is the vis-a-vis relationship of Joseph and Jesus or Jesus or Yahushua or contracted Yeshua and their brethren. Firstly, both were hated by their brethren. Why? Why were they hated? Both of them had superior claims that were rejected by their brethren. Like the superior claims of the King of Kings, many of our Hebrew Israelite folks You understand? Who are half civilized now because they recognize they're Hebrews, but they're not fully civilized because they reject the authority of the King of Kings of Ethiopia. So they reject the superior claims. Then we have the fact that the brethren conspired against them to slay them. This is what comes out of a lot of the so-called Hebrew Israelites' mouths concerning Rastafari, Ethiopian, in particular Haile Selassie. And let's not bemuse ourselves, brethren, even I and I. So we need to be forewarned and to be forearmed, both naturally and spiritually. Now, Joseph was in intent and figure slain by his brethren. He was slain by his brethren, as was Christ. Each of them became a blessing among the Gentiles. So people will criticize his imperial majesty because they see him among the Gentiles. They see all the pictures of him with all the so-called people of the world and all the world leaders. And in their ignorance and error, it would just increase their own envy. But reject not the light. Don't reject the light, because the light and the fire is from one source. If you reject the light, then you're going to get the fire. For our God is a consuming fire. Now, so each of them became a blessing among the Gentiles, and we ourselves are among the Gentiles. You see, we as Rastafari, you understand, as the people, are to be that bride for Christ in his kingly character, as both of them, Joseph and Jesus, became a blessing among the Gentiles and gained a Gentile bride. So we can see this figure, you understand, and the intent of this figure both working in Ethiopia concerning Rastafari, Negustafari, and Kedemawi Haile Selassie. We can see that there were those Ethiopians who were and still are haters of our kinsman redeemer, our godfather, Kedemawi Haile Selassie, even prior to the coronation. Like the Lijasu crowd out there. You understand? Like the Lijasu crowd that is out there even to this very day. But here's the key thing for us. We have gained a blessing, a barakat. We who have been sold and scattered among the Gentiles. And we are to, as Revelation states, are to prepare ourselves. You understand? As a bride prepareth herself. You understand, for her wedding. And this is a part of our preparation spiritually, the readings and these feedings. But here's the key. As Joseph reconciled his brethren to himself, and afterward he exalted them, so it will be with Christ in his kingly character and his Hebrew Israelite brethren. But remember the order. You see, that first there must be reconciliation before there is exaltation. You see, some would like to exalt themselves as Hebrew Israelites, but don't recognize the true king of Israel, Negus Neges Kedemawi Haile Selassie. And the root of it, this hate for Christ and his kingly character, this evil intended against Christ and his kingly character, in every dispensation of time is always linked to the same mythic, you understand, or mystic, if you will, you understand, but the same parabolic metaphors. As we look at Joseph being a type of Christ, as we look at Yehoshua HaMashiach, or Jesus Christ, as we look at Christ in his kingly character, Kedemawi Haile Selassie and I Rastafari, first there must be reconciliation. First, there must be reconciliation, and then, and only then, can there be exaltation. Exaltation, apart from that, is like when Christ says, if you don't enter in through the door, and you come in another way, you come in as a thief. You see what I'm saying? You come in as a thief. So we have to enter in through the door, and the door to his imperial majesty's house, our father, my father's house, is in and through Jesus Christos. It's in and through his Christ. So it is written, and so it will be done. So Christ, in his kingly character, in this ministry, in this time, is seeking to reconcile his Hebrew, or we can say for those who don't know themselves, his Negro or Negroid brethren. Food for thought. If you're hungry, if you're wise, eat up. So until next time, stay tuned. Stay in the truth of the King of Kings and his Christ. And Shabbat Shalom, Senbet Salam. More to come, Yah willing. Love you all. In him and through him. Salam.
And when the Lamb opened the seventh seal, silence covered the sky, covered the sky, covered the sky, covered the sky.